Hello everybody, my name is Erica and welcome to my channel Ginger Books, or welcome back if you're a continuing subscriber or viewer. Obviously you can see that our New Year's plans have derailed just a little bit. Just to kind of explain a little bit what's been going on, since November, I have had family members pass away. I'm also dressed up, not just for this video, but I'm also dressed up for another person's visitation who passed away that wasn't in my life for very long, but in the short amount of time she was in it, she definitely did impact me, and I also have one of her horses that she trained, that would be Ty. So she definitely impacted my life, even the short time that she was in it. I don't know exactly what was going on in my mental headspace for the past few months, and it finally just kind of burst out of me last week. Finally, everything kind of just waited enough that I just could not hold it all in anymore, and it ended up me pretty much kind of losing myself for a little bit one day. No, I didn't like harm myself. I didn't harm anybody else or anything. It's just, it finally just came out in a huge crying mess of just how much pent up like stress and weight that I was carrying with work and just dealing with funerals and family member deaths that I just, it finally came out. But now I kind of feel better, but I do not recommend obviously bottling up and ignoring the problems. If you need to deal with it, you need to deal with it and make time to deal with it. And that's another, I kind of add that as a goal to my New Year's resolution list personally for me, is to kind of look at dealing with things in a different way instead of, usually I can deal with them pretty well, but am I really actually dealing with my problems? Whether it's stress in life or emotional stress or anything like that. So that's a new goal. We'll go into that later on in a vlog or something. I'll let you guys know. Our New Year's resolutions for this channel were derailed a little bit, but I am excited to try to get back on the tracks and keep chugging along. I don't really have a huge lot of plans for this channel quite yet when it comes to content. I'm still thinking through content while I'm also dealing with the event planning at work. So trying to find a balance a little bit and trying to find, create fun new content for you guys. So until then, I want to do some fun book takes because I don't do a lot of book takes on here. I've only done a few, and it seems that a lot of people in the BookTuber community that watch other BookTubers love book takes. So I decided in continuing my journey that I kind of started in December of just you getting to know me a lot more and kind of building a nice little friendship circle here, we're in safe space. I saw this on my For You page, but I never clicked on it, and I really wanted to give that BookTuber credit for these 20 questions, but of course your For You page refreshes every time you go back to it, so I could not, it disappeared. If I can find them again, I will link them down in the description below later on. So we're going to do the 20 questions book tag. Now I'm taking the questions off of what blogger CG Drews off of Paper Fury is doing, and I'll link it down below. She posted these 20 questions on her blog 2 years ago in February, and it's, from what I understand, it's the same questions throughout, and I'm not 100% sure who actually originally created this, so I will, once I find out, I will definitely put it down in the description below to give them credit. But for now, we'll give CG Drews credit for having the questions on here for me. So without further ado, let's get into the questions. All right, so there are 20 questions, and I already kind of briefly looked at them, so some of them may have longer answers than others. So I will try to keep this short and sweet because I know this video is going to be a little long, but I may go off the rails a little bit on some of these questions. So question number one, how many books are too many for your series? Don't really care how many books are in a series. I really don't. If you can keep a reader enticed throughout, you can have as many as 20 books if you wanted to. I mean, if you want to consider manga as a, you know, manga series, they have, you know, some of them have utmost to maybe ballpark 50 to 100 volumes in a manga series. Or, I mean, as short as, I believe, the Sailor Moon is only 12. So, I don't have a preference. The only time when I feel like the series is kind of too long is when they're either revisiting old plot points or, I don't want to say motifs, what's the word? Tropes that are just, at this point, kind of just not making sense with the whole story or the plot. Or it's just a stalemate, which House of Night series I will have to bring in. The House of Night series kind of does get stale in the middle, but I understand what the authors are doing to set up for the end of the series. But still, we could have done without a couple of the books. But I really don't think a series is too long as readers are really enticed. You keep readers enticed with cliffhangers, plot twists, drama. Number two, how do you feel about cliffhangers? I love them and I hate them. I love them because it's a really cool trope and way for authors to keep you second guessing and to make you buy, if they have sequel books or anything like that, to know more. But I hate the waiting game, especially if they leave off in a cliffhanger and there's not a next book yet in the series. I absolutely hate that. But I understand. It keeps the reader wanting to know more and will buy the next book. Greatest example is the Truly Devious series, because she leaves off in cliffhangers and but it makes you want to read more. It's a wonderful device, but it angers me because I need the next book. Question number three, hardcover or paperback? So personally me, I love hardcovers. Most of my shelves, as you can tell, are hardcovers. I do have paperbacks, but most of them are hardcovers. I like the aesthetic of hardcovers. However, I understand that they can sometimes be harder to display or read over and over again because you can break the spine. So that's why I love paperbacks. If I ever want to annotate a book, I always get a used paperback copy that I don't feel that I'm damaging the hardcover, and I get special editions and hardcovers. I prefer hardcovers, but I like either or, to be honest. Number four, favorite book. I can't answer this straight. Right now, my favorite book of 2020 is probably A Court of Mist and Fury, but I love the whole Court of Thorns and Roses series. Like, I can't just pick a favorite book. 2019 was A Stalking Jack the Ripper, but my favorite book was probably Capturing the Devil, which is the last book. You can tell I kind of like last books in the series more. I love that in series entirely, so you can't make me pick a favorite book because I have a lot of favorite books that I go to. Number five, least favorite book. Now I do have that one. And right now that takes the top number one on my list is The After, After by Anna Todd. What I read, I only made it halfway through before I had to put the book away because I could not stand the whole mental manipulation that was going on. Pretty much abuse that was going on. I couldn't handle it. Like, I just could not read it. I know some people really love that series, but I couldn't handle it. I had to put it down, and I'm like, I can't read this. Like, I mentally cannot handle reading this book right now. I don't like that book. I might give it another shot if I feel up to it, but I couldn't stand it because they went more in detail about the manipulation that Harden did towards Tessa, all of this stuff, and I couldn't. Question number six, love triangles, yes or no? I think at this point, I might have made it kind of clear that I love love triangles. I mean, I love Cassandra Clare's work, and she puts love triangles all the way around her. The sequel series, I believe, has a love triangle. The original series, The Mortal Instruments, has a love triangle. The prequel series, Infernal Devices, has a love triangle. Like, except that love triangle I love because that was complex. I love complex love triangles. So, yes, I do love love triangles. And also in Escaping from Houdini in the Stalking Jack the Ripper series, there's a love triangle. Then there is, it's not really a love triangle in A Court of Thorns and Roses, but I would kind of consider it, even though there was an extreme, like, hate to love at that point. But, yes, I love love triangles. I guess I already haven't made it clear now. Number seven, the most recent book you couldn't finish. That would probably be After by Anna Todd. Number eight, a book you're currently reading. So currently, like I said in my TBR, I am still reading Lady Midnight from the Dark Artifices series by Cassandra Clare, which is a sequel series to The Mortal Instruments, and I am reading book four of Harry Potter, which is Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire by J.K. Rowling. Last book you recommended to somebody. So I have recommended two series that I have read, and of course they're my the series of top series of 2020 and top series of 2019. So that's the Stalking Jack Ripper series by Carrie Maniscalco and A Court of Thorns and Roses by Sarah J. Maas. I recommended them both to my two of my friends just because I felt like they would have. One loves high fantasy and the other one kind of likes historical period, kind of talking about the sciences behind cadavers and everything like that because she is a mortician. So, actually, both of them are morticians. So, I mean, both of them probably would like that, especially Victorian and set in Victorian London, talking about criminal cases. That is an actual real criminal case. So, figured they would like Stalking Jack the Ripper and Court of Thorns and Roses for one of my friends who loves high fantasy fairy type stories. Number 10, oldest book you read by publication date. I would have to say it is the Epics of Gilgamesh, or it's Epic of Gilgamesh. Sorry, I probably just pronounced that wrong. I read it for I read it for one of my history classes in college. 11, newest book you've read by publication date. What is the newest book I've read? I would have to say The Hand on the Wall by Maureen Johnson is the newest one that I can think of off the top of my head. But I feel like that's wrong. 12, favorite author. I have a lot of favorite authors. But right now, the top three on my list is probably Cassandra Clare, Carrie Maniscalco, and Sarah J. Maas. Not in that order because I'm not going to pick an order, but it's those three. 13, buying books or borrowing books. So I got this inspiration of how I kind of felt about borrowing books or Emma from Emma Books. Go check out her YouTube channel. She released very fun content, and I get a lot of inspiration from her along with Jessie the Reader. So go check those two out. I feel I only use like Libby to borrow books for like audiobooks because I don't want to pay the outrageous prices that Amazon sometimes makes you pay. So I have this thing where I don't borrow books if I can buy them myself. If I have the money and I can buy the book, I will just buy the book. Because I feel like libraries are for people who may not have be fortunate enough to buy books all the time and still want to keep reading. So that's why I do not borrow from my library. I know that's kind of like not supporting your library, but in a way, I'm supporting the people who support the library, if that kind of makes sense. So the only time I'll ever borrow a book is if I don't see myself wanting to keep it, but I want to read it, mostly for work. 14, a book you just like that everyone seems to love. After series by Anna Todd. Right now, I just like it. I may give it another try and try to stomach through it. And maybe that might be fun for me to read a series that I dislike for this channel just to see the lulls of my reactions. So let me know if that's an idea you would like to see and comment down below. 15, bookmarks or dog ears? So I'm either or. I know that's like a huge controversial topic, but I don't care for either or. Like, or I should say I don't mind either or, sorry. I have bookmarks. I love having them, and the bookmarks are for the books that I'm not annotating and are not writing in. And especially my special editions, if I read those copies, I definitely don't want dog ears or anything on that because they're close to my heart. I paid them with my own money or I got them in a box. So, which I still kind of paid my own money if I got them in a box. I will dog ear books, use books that I'm annotating. So again, I'm either or. And the only time if I'm desperate enough and I don't have a bookmark but I need to mark that page because I know I'll forget, I will dog ear, but make sure that it's not like a crease that it's gonna be permanent. Number 16, a book you can always reread. Anything by Sarah J. Maas, Cassandra Clare, and Carrie Maniscalco. 17, can you read while listening to music? So that, I know that there's a lot of mixed reviews on this because a lot of people can't focus, but I do read with music in the background, like K-pop, because I cannot have white noise unless I'm really invested. then I may not have anything in the background. So I'll put on like some like spooky Victorian mansion ASMR or cozy reading nook ASMR, or I'll put on K-pop quietly in the background and I will read. It helps me focus my brain a little bit more, knowing that I don't feel alone in the room, because white noise bothers me and I don't know why. It makes me feel like I'm by myself and it makes me kind of panicky. Number 18, one point of view or multiple point of views. Again, the series that I've read, like House of Night series, Cassandra, anything by Cassandra Clare, later on in the Modal Instruments, and also in some of her books, later other books, Sarah J. Maas, Truly Devious by Maureen Johnson, that series, multiple point of views don't bother me. I love the one person point of view, but I feel like it gives a diversity when you give other side characters voices, so that's why I like. So I guess I could say I kind of gravitate more towards multiple point of views. I used to absolutely hate it because I could never keep track, but once I got into the rhythm of things, absolutely love it. I don't care for either. I mean, I don't mind either or. 19. Do you read a book in one sitting or over multiple days? I guess that depends on how invested I am in this story. I know that I practically read, once I got into it, A Court of Thorns and Roses series in probably a week. If I'm really that invested, sometimes I can't put it down and I will finish it in one day, depending on how big the book is. But sometimes I want the book to last, so sometimes I'll try to expand it, but if I'm not really invested into reading or the story, it will take me a while. Number 20, and the last question. Who do you tag? So I don't really have anybody to tag. So again, until I get more BookTuber friends and bookish friends, I won't have anybody to tag in these, but I really enjoyed this book tag. It's 20 questions that now that you know about me and my reading habits. Let me know any other book tags that you would love to see me do. Just comment down below and I will try to see if I can get them done. I am busy at work, so some of the book tags, like when it comes to like the bookshelves or anything like that, and since they're not done, I might not be able to do, but any other fun book tags that I have not seen that doesn't require too much work with my work schedule, because we're planning a lot of big events this year. So I'm pretty swamped, but I'm trying to make time. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you loved this chaotic video, and if you want to stick around for more, please hit the subscribe button and that bell notification so you are notified. I post fun bookish content on Tuesdays like this one, and fun Sims content on Fridays. Again, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great start to your week, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!